Hey guys, Joshua Peterson with Peterson Electric here. I wanted to talk to you today about a GFCI receptacle. A lot of people say GFI, which is fine slang term, but the proper terminology is a ground fault circuit interrupter. Basically, this is a fairly generic one. It actually doesn't even have a TR stamp on it for the new tamper proof with the plastic tabs to keep your kids from lighting themselves up. This is just an older style GFI. It's got a red and black push button. It's really a generic style. Personally, I like Levington or Passon Seymour. They have a better brand. This has definitely got Home Depot written on it, which is fine. I just prefer sometimes to have a really high quality on a GFI because I don't have to go back and warranty them because they never give me warranty money. So bottom line is when we put in one of these, the purpose of this is a lot like your hair dryer. If you look at the end of your hair dryer on your plug, you've got what they call the same kind of thing. It's basically a GFI. And that is if you drop the hair dryer in the sink, you will not get electrocuted because it will cut out. A lot of people think that their breakers are protecting them from electrocution. Not true. Breakers are there to protect your wire and your house from over ampacity draws, dead shorts, and short circuits or ground faults. But what a GFI protects you from is becoming electrocuted. They are required in all the areas of the house, basically, where you do not have a finished area, such as carpet, hardwood, or tile. So outside, garage, basements, crawl spaces, unfinished areas is where you're going to see a GFCI. So when somebody goes and plugs something in, if their cord is shorting out or the appliance motor, like a drill, is not working properly, what's going to end up happening is that GFCI reset button is going to cut out on you. And on the back of one of these GFCIs, you're going to see something called line and load. Now, this is for you brave souls out there that want to mess with your house. Line, it means the power coming in, and load means the power going out, so downstream. And when you do this, you cannot mix up your neutrals, and you want to make sure your hot and your downside is actually lining up correctly on the line and load. Fairly easy to wire. But if you have a bunch of wires in there, you may not want to mess with it. Because when you start seeing three or four blacks in there and three or four white commons in there, that's because of the fact that you've got to know where you're feeding your load side and what's your line. You can just pigtail all of them out and put in just one receptacle and it'll kill just that opening. Or you can actually download and kill a bunch of other outlets so that way you're not putting in $20 devices in each opening. You're just putting in a normal outlet. Bottom line, guys, GFIs are real important. Kitchens and bathrooms, especially if you're renting your house or you have a property management taking care of it, as well if you just have a lot of children in there. It is real common for someone to have a stereo sink right there in their bathroom and then bump it into the water and then go to grab it, and that's when you're going to get locked up pretty hard. So anyways, guys, GFCIs, want to tell you about them. Good thing to get. Levington or Passon Seymour is what I like. And I don't spare a little cheap expense on things like that. I definitely buy the best of the best and put them in and make sure it's put in right. Make sure your connections are tight. If you need help with that, we can do something as simple as that for you. Our number is 720-641-8866. Thanks, guys.